Good afternoon, all the juries, organizer, and participant. Myself, Rinkita Giretkar from Sri Mathura Das Mohta College of Science, Nagpur. I am studying in PG final year. My topic name is for review study on forensic entomology. Next slide, ma'am. Introduction, ma'am. Starting with the introduction, forensic entomology is the science of collecting and analyzing evidence to aid in forensic investigation. The body and the decomposers are telling you what happened if you can only understand the languages. Forensic entomology is the use of insects and their arthropod relatives that inhabit decomposing remains to aid legal investigation. Most of the time, it is used in estimation of time since death or post-mortem interval. Forensic entomology not only used in arthropod biology, but it also involves other sciences, introduction fields like chemistry and genetics, exploiting their inherent synergy through the use of DNA in forensic entomology. This field employs the use of insects such as flies, maggots, and beetles to reveal critical details of a crime scene. Next slide, ma'am. Then the review of the case study in forensic entomology. First is child neglect and forensic entomology. On the skin surface under the diaper, third instar larvae of the false table fly, Muscanus stabulans, fallen, and the laser house fly, Phania canicularis, were found. From the development times of the flies, it was estimated that the anal genital area of the child had not been cleaned for about 14 days and that death occurred only 6 to 8 days prior to discovery of the body. Second case is toxicological analysis of insect of the corpse. Entomotoxicology as a subset of forensic entomology can be analysis of carcass, feeding insect to detecting of drugs or toxins as well as the cause and manner of death in cases of antemortem drugs intoxication. The aim of this study was to determine the presence and quantity of morphine in insects on the carcasses and compare with decomposing carcass. Detection of drug in insects, which is actually a reflection of the cause of death, is possible. Third is uses of DNA marker and entomology. Through analysis of the morphology of blowfly larvae in comparison with the ambient environment at a death scene, critical information regarding crime can be acquired. Interpretations can then be made in identifying the average time since the death of an animal. The following case illustrate that DNA typing has to embedded into the course of biological investigation and interpreted in the light of the actual findings at the scene. In October 1997, a body that was in a state of severe decay was scrutinized for insect colonization to determine the colonization interval or postmortem interval. Different fly species developed within a different times. Therefore, estimation of colonization time is only possible if the insect species is known. In such a cases, the insects can be used to estimate the time elapsed since death. The species of maggots, especially that of younger ones, is difficult to identify. For this reason, a quick, inexpensive, and reliable DNA test by using RAPIDS was applied in the aforementioned cases. With it, at least the distinction of different maggot species was possible. The pupae found on the floor beneath the corpse were not related to the maggots found inside the body bag. Their developmental stage was of no relatives in this case. The age of maggots was calculated and used for estimating the colonization time. Then the conclusion. In order to come to any conclusion on postmortem interval, DNA analysis, medico-legal field, and data collected from insect, weather, environment, and time have to be analyzed collectively. The various arthropod species not only provide specific times since death, but it's also take part in toxicological analysis. Insects that feed on tissue that contain substances relevant under toxicological aspects will, in many cases, ingest and store these toxicological relevant substances in their own tissue. Extraction of the substance out of the insects was successfully used in cases in which the corpse was too decomposed to perform toxicological analysis on tissue samples. By using forensic entomology, we can identify duration of decomposition of carcasses and the cause of death. This is the references, and thank you.